Hello and welcome back to a short video. A while ago I ordered this 6-channel FLYSKY T6 transmitter for the YMFC quadcopter project, and I must admit that I was pretty skeptic about the quality when I ordered it. I mean, what can you expect for $50? This Futaba transmitter that I use for my helicopter, for example, costs almost 10 times as much. Now, I must admit that one glitch will definitely cause a crash when flying a helicopter like this, and repairing it is ridiculously expensive. And that is why I will keep using this Futaba transmitter for this helicopter. Okay, back to the FLYSKY T6 transmitter. I must say that I'm still very impressed by the quality and feel of the gimbals, especially for the price. Not those cheap plastic thingies that you get on normal cheap transmitters, but solid play-free gimbals. Now, the reason that I made this video is because I recently started experimenting with the Ardupilot flight controller. It's a relatively cheap solution, and you have many flight modes like stable, altitude hold, GPS and return to home. All these functions can be selected with the use of only one channel, so you only lose one channel for selecting the different functions. Okay, here's my problem. The T6 is a 6-channel transmitter with limited software functionality. 4 channels are already in use by the roll, pitch, jaw and throttle function. The 2 remaining channels can be used for other purposes. The transmitter has 4 on-off switches and 2 dials. In the software, you can assign any switch or dial to any of the 2 remaining channels. But there is no possibility to connect or mix multiple switches to one channel, so you can't make 4 independent settings on one channel. Now, I could use the mixing function, but then I have to use a 6th channel for mixing, and I want to use this channel for something like tilting the gimbal. Long story short, I will try something else. If you have a look at this dial, you can see that ground is connected to one of the pins of the potentiometer, and 3.3 volts to the other pin. By turning the dial, the wiper is moving between the ground and the 3.3 volts. The wiper is connected to the analog input of the microcontroller and is used for channel calculations. Important to know is that the microcontroller is running on 3.3 volt and not 5 volt like the Arduino Uno. So I thought about it for a while and I came up with this. This is a basic voltage divider based on 3 resistors. With 2 switches, I can select the different voltages. This wire is connected to the analog input of the microcontroller. This is a 2-position switch and will always connect the output wire to the 3.3 volt regardless the position of the other switch. The other switch is a 3-position switch. When switched in the lowest position, the output wire is connected to ground. In the middle position, the output wire is connected to this position of the voltage divider. As a result, the voltage on the output wire is 1.73 volt. When switched in the upper position, this resistor is shorted or bypassed, and the voltage on the output wire will be 2.27 volt. This way I can create 3 flight modes with the 3-position switch and a return to home function that is completely independent of the position of the flight mode switch. For safety reasons, always remove the batteries or unplug the battery connector. Only thing left to do is to connect everything together. And with everything in place, it's time to test the results. Let's first test the circuit with the channel menu of the transmitter. Okay, this looks good. Now let's check it with the Mission Planner software. Okay, so I think we have a winner here. The next thing on my to-do list is the battery voltage indicator on the display of the transmitter. When I measured the voltage of the battery, I noticed that there is almost a 0.5 volt difference between the reading on the screen and the multimeter. When using normal alkaline batteries, this is not a problem. But when using rechargeable batteries, this voltage difference is a bit annoying. Let me explain. The transmitter runs on 5 volt with the use of a voltage regulator that you can see here. The 5 volt is used for the 2.4 GHz transmitter. The other voltage regulator provides the 3.3 volts for the microcontroller. In short, the transmitter will still work fine on 8 volts. Now, the battery warning starts at 9 volt. Because there is a difference of 0.5 volt, the battery alarm already starts at 9.5 volts. That's around 1.19 volt per cell. When using new rechargeable battery, this is not a problem. But when the number of charge cycles increases, the internal resistance is also increasing and the voltage during normal use can easily drop below the 1.19 volts. The battery will still have enough power for a full day, but the battery warning is already beeping. And that is why I want the battery voltage to be correct. These resistors and capacitors form the battery voltage divider for the analog input of the microcontroller. Simplified, it looks like this. The battery voltage is divided by two resistors of 39 and 10 kiloohm. After some calculations, I figured out that I could put a 700 kiloohm resistor in parallel with a 39 kiloohm resistor. To be more flexible, I used a 470k resistor in series with a 1 megaohm potentiometer. When I connect the wires of the potentiometer to the 39k resistor, I can now adjust the voltage as you can see here. And that's another problem solved. And now I can use this transmitter with the Ardupilot flight controller and still have one channel available for tilting the camera. Thank you for watching and see you next time.